Ladies and gentlemen, our experience in Germany demonstrates that protecting the climate by using renewable energy is not a burden but a stimulus for the economy. It is cost-effective way of reaching energy security with domestic and sustainable energy sources while also preventing national or international struggle over resources. Many nations in the world, such as India, South Africa and Brazil, have followed the successful path of Germany's feed-in tariff law. But in USA, we have only a discussion, and in some other countries, like in Germany also, and in Europe, in some countries, and reduced discussion against renewable energies. I cannot understand this because of this great success here. In 2009, I published a paper in Washington, D.C., which contains the most important political measures that made feed-in tariff law such a successful. Unfortunately, I do not have time today to go into the details of this paper. You will find a copy down and you can download it from my homepage to learn all the most important details for such a feed-in law. Such principles are: we need a privileged grid access, an attractive feed-in tariff that the investment is secure. The feed-in cost must be distributed via electricity price and not paid by tax money. This was a failure in Spain. Partly the tariff was paid by the tax money, and then the finance minister said it is too heavy a burden for my budget, and so he had to cancel this very successful strategy in Spain for renewable energies, especially in photovoltaics. And we see we do not need a cap for the amount of renewable generated, and we need a guaranteed feed-in period at least 20 years, so it is in Germany. And it is also important, without of this law, all the obstacles through approval procedures must be reduced. We have a lot of obstacles, and this have to be cancelled. Ladies and gentlemen, a fuller supply of renewable energy would be the most decisive contribution to global climate protection, energy security, conflict prevention, and healthcare expansion. This is also a great opportunity for those pioneering countries to become leaders in the industry and to create many new jobs in the export sector. What is it crazy to think the others have to do the industry and have to take the burden? No, by themselves, we could make it by ourselves to make new employment and new industry process. The leadership is the strategy, what is successful. With the growing capacity of mass production, renewable energy technology will also become cheaper and cheaper. With the exception of bioenergy, renewable energies do not contain fuel costs, which will make them cheaper with no competition from oil, natural gas, coal and uranium in the coming years. By contrast, the cost of the conventional fuels will rise in the next few years due to the scarcity of resources, which will bring along serious problems. Scientists of the Energy Watch Group and others have already proved the world has passed its oil peak. With 3% annual decline in the coming years, global oil production will decline in 2030 to about 50% of today's production. Even the conservative International Energy Agency in Paris has warned that the world is facing serious economic problems due to the increasing shortage of the availability of oil. Since natural gas, coal and uranium resources are of limited availability, they do not stand to have a chance to balance the decline of oil. At the same time, nuclear security risks and costs are rising. Germany has already recognized this, and nuclear phase-out law was adopted in 2002. And I'm sure the election yesterday will stabilize this law very clearly. No political party in the meantime in Germany still supports the construction of a new nuclear reactors. There is no renaissance in the world, there is only a discussion in the world over nuclear renaissance and no reality of a big increasing of renewable, of a nuclear sector. We should recognize nuclear electricity brings only 2% of the whole energy share of the world energy consumption. It is such a few amount. When we would double the nuclear sector, we would have 4% of the energy demand in the world from nuclear. What such a crazy thinking. Ladies and gentlemen, climate change requires not only the conversion to renewable energy, but a further strategy too. The switch towards renewable energy would indeed mean that nearly no more CO2 would be issued into the atmosphere. But the concentration of 385 parts per million CO2 in the atmosphere is already too high and has led to unexpected problems and risks. So I fear 2 degrees Celsius as a target for the world. It is warming up the world and we will earn more disasters. So the targets must be, it is necessary to create a second strategy to clean the atmosphere of CO2 with a target of 330 parts per million. And again, this is achievable with new technologies such as hydrothermal carbonization combined with reforesting. Thermal carbonization can turn plants and its side products into biochar in a couple of hours. Biochar can be used in 3 ways, as fuel in a coal plant, as a chemical base, and most notable for CO2 binding in soil. The storage of biochar deposits atmospheric CO2 into soil. At the same time, water storage and generativity rise with the result that more food and bioenergy can be produced. This works better with organic farming than with intensive farming. And it is possible, you can find also last week published paper from me for a new climate protection strategy. I published it in California and you will find a summary of this paper also as a copy when you are interested. Climate protection policies are very, very important. You see, we need not the certificate system with emission trading. Emission trading is very unsuccessful. We need other laws. Laws for feed-in tariffs, tax reliefs for renewables. We need cancelling subsidies for intensive agriculture, for fossil and nuclear energy, and for fossil chemistry. Research and education offensive for renewables and organic farming, reduction of approval obstacles, and we must depose big areas for reforesting. This is a policy for climate protection and not what is discussed in Copenhagen. If we put together all political framework for 100% renewable energies and cleaning the atmosphere of CO2, we can reach climate protection, we can reach energy security, prevention of conflicts over oil, we can lower or stop nuclear proliferation, and we can avoid disasters like now the oil disaster in Gulf of Mexico. And we can create a rapid economic development with many new employment opportunities. Ladies and gentlemen, what do we want more? Let's do it to go such a strategy with 100% renewables in 2 or 3 decades. Thank you very much for your attention.
Great. Thank you so much, Mr. Fell. We have a panel later on, and he will be sitting on the panel, so I will propose your questions. Later on, we open up the panel. Just keep them a couple of minutes for yourself.